Hello everyone, in this video we'll see how to create this really cool broken mirror or glass effect that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop and let's go to File, New, and let's put 3000 for the width and 3000 for the height. I will keep the resolution to 72 RGB in color mode and I will press OK. Alright, now we're gonna place the image that we'll be using, so we'll go and open the image that I'm gonna use. I will open it in a new tab. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command A to select everything and Ctrl Command C to copy and Ctrl or Command V to paste. Just like that. Alright. So the main idea is to have the focus of the image to be in the eye. So that's why I'm gonna try to actually put the rulers just right in that center of this image. And I have the rulers in here open. If you don't have them open, you can just press Ctrl Command R on your keyboard and they will open. And I have them set to percentage. So I'm just gonna take one and put it in the 50% range and another one in the 50% range. And now I can go and place the eye when I want to be the focus of the image. Just like that. Place it exactly in the center. Alright, I think it looks really cool. Now, let's call this image our main image. And I will make another copy by pressing Ctrl Command J. And I will put it down and I will call it blur image. Alright. And this one I'm gonna right click and convert it to smart object because I'm gonna apply a blur. And let's say that maybe I don't like the amount of blur, I can go ahead and change it in the future if I want to. Alright. Now I will go and open the texture that we'll be using, and by the way, this texture, it will be available for everybody to download. It's like a giveaway for you guys. You will find it down in the link of in the description below. And if you want another premium textures of the glass, you will find it in another link. All right but this one, it will be free for everybody to use. All right so I will take it and open it in a new tab. And I'm gonna press Ctrl Command A to select everything, Ctrl Command C to copy, Ctrl Command W to close, and I will paste it by pressing Ctrl Command V. Alright, now we have it set in the center too. So let me choose a really good area. Maybe I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T and I will rotate this glass. And then I'm gonna right click and choose Flip Horizontal. And maybe flip it again, and I'm gonna flip it vertical this time because I want a part of the mouth and the nose to be showing, something like that. Maybe I will make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, something like that. I think it will be fine, and I will want to click on this check mark. All right now I'm gonna call this glass. All right now we have all the component that we need. Let me just delete this background because we don't need it. Now let me actually remove these rulers because we don't need them as well. All right now I want actually to keep this part of the eyes to be clear, and I want to blur all the part that's under the glass, if that makes sense. And to do that, we can easily do it by loading the selection of the glass itself and then apply it as a layer mask on the blur image. But before we're gonna do that, let me first hide the main image and hide the glass for now. And I will select the blurred, put blurred image, and then I will go to filter. I will choose blur gallery and I will choose field blur. And for the blur, I will put like 25 for now, and I will press OK. All right, now we have a really nice, decent amount of blur. Now we can go ahead and apply a layer mask on this. So to do that, I will select the glass texture, this one, and I'm gonna load the selection of this layer. So to do that, you can just press Ctrl or Command on your keyboard and one click, and this will load the selection. So while you are pressing Ctrl or Command, one click, and this will load it. All right, so I'm gonna hide this for now, and then I will select the blurred image, and I'm gonna one click on this layer mask, and as you can see, it will apply the blur only in this outside area, but not in the center, because the center we want it to be unblurred. So I'm gonna make the main image visible again, and as you can see, it will make everything clear because we don't have any layer mask so far. So to do that, we're gonna actually make a copy of this blurred layer or the blurred layer mask. And to make a copy, you can just press Alt or Option on your keyboard. And while you are doing that, one click on the layer mask and it will make a copy of it and copy it on the top. And as you can see, now we need to invert it. So to do that, you can just double click on the layer mask and this will properties will open. And then you can just one click on this invert. And another way to do it is by pressing Ctrl Command I. Alright, now we have everything set on place. So I'm gonna make the glass layer visible again, and I will change the blending mode of it to screen. And there we go. We have in here this part blurred and this one clear. And that's exactly what we want. Alright, now I want actually to make this part of the glass. I want them to make them more visible. And to do that, we're gonna actually make another copy of this glass texture. So I'm gonna select it and then I press Ctrl Command J, and this will create a copy. And then I will change the blending mode of it to overlay. But as you can see, it's a little bit dark and I don't want that. So to fix this, we're gonna actually open the blending options. So while I'm selecting the glass copy, I will go to this FX icon and choose blending options. And then in the blend if area, I will make sure that I'm using this layer. So I would go to this black slider in here, and by pressing Alt or Option, I will one click on it and it will split it. And then I will move it all the way to the white. And this way, all the black part, they will disappear, as you can see. But if you want, you can play with it to the amount that you want. For me, I will make it all the way to the white, and I will press OK. Now we have a really nice emphasized details to in the white area alone, and that's exactly what I want. All right, the other thing that I want to add is a little bit of grain in this glass area, just to give it a little bit of texture. And to do that, again, we're gonna load the selection of the glass by pressing Ctrl or Command, and I will one click on the glass. And then I will create a new layer and I will call it grain. And then I will go to edit and I will choose fill. And in the content, I will make sure that I'm selecting the 50% gray and I will press OK. Now I'm gonna press Ctrl Command D to deselect. And then I will go to filter and I will choose filter gallery. And in the texture folder, I will open it and I will choose grain. And let me actually delete this one. All right, now you would have it set 50 by 50, but for me I only want the intensity to be 30, and for the contrast I'm gonna change it to 15, and in the grain type I will change it to enlarge. All right, and I will press OK. Now I'm gonna change the blending mode of it to soft light, and now if I zoom in, you can find a really nice texture in the glass, and that's what I want. All right, so the other thing that I want to add is a little bit of shadow in the glass that would be reflected on the model face. And to do that, you can use any of this texture that you have of the glass. For me, I will use the glass texture that's in here. So while I'm selecting the glass texture, I will go to the blending options. And then I will choose drop shadow. All right, so I will keep the blending mode set to multiply. But for the color, I will change it to the skin color, or to this one in here, exactly this one, and I will press OK. And I will keep the opacity set to 35 for now. And for the distance, I'm gonna use my cursor to choose distance myself. So I'm just gonna try to follow the shadow that we already have in the face. So I think it's somewhere like this. Yeah, I think it will be something like that. All right. And then I'm gonna change the size to a little bit to blend with the image, something like that. I think this looks really cool, and I will press OK. And now we have it blend perfectly with the image itself. Now the last thing that I want to add is a little bit of adjustment to the blurred image, and also another adjustment layer on top of everything. So let's go and select the blurred image in here, and then I will go to adjustment, and I'm gonna choose exposure. And I will clip it to the blurred layer, and I'm gonna put -0.5 in the exposure, and this would give it a little bit of dark to the image that is down, to give it that realistic look of the glass. As you can see, this is before and this is after. All right, now I will go on top and I will apply another adjustment. So I will go and choose gradient map. And I'm going to change the gradient for the black stop. I will choose a brownish color, something like this one. All right. And for the white stop, I will change it to a bluish color, maybe something like that. And I'll press OK and OK. And then I'm going to change the blending mode of it to soft light. And I will drop down the opacity and I will go a little bit up just to see the best percentage of this, or something like 40%. It will look really cool. Maybe a little bit down, see before and after. I think it looks really cool. And there we go, we have our broken glass effect, and that will be all for our tutorial. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know it's for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.